So far, we have seen how to read data using ReadStream in streaming fashion and create a data frame out of it. Now let's go ahead and try to apply data frame operations as well as Spark SQL to process that data frame and create a new data frame. And then we'll actually see how to write that into different targets. For preview purpose, we'll be using memory as the sink, but later we will actually see how to write to other formats as well. That being said, this is the logic which we have executed earlier to create the data frame. I am running that again by using SBT console. Here we are trying to get the department count. If you actually look at the data by going into the OPG genlogs logs and by opening access.log, you see the file contains the log messages using standard log format. We have the IP address at the beginning and then a couple of hyphens to represent some non-existing data. Then we have the timestamp. We have the endpoint and other information. So to get the records or messages which have the department endpoint, we have to extract this information by using regular string manipulation functions and compare with the department. Once we filter for these records, then we can extract the department name using this information. So we have to come up with logic where this can be extracted. Once we extract the department name, we can group the data using the department name and we can get the count. However, we will be getting the total count every interval, which is not the desired output. Typically, when we actually perform these kind of operations, we want to get count every minute or every 20 seconds or every hour, whatever it is. It is called as granularity. We have to identify the lowest granularity and we have to aggregate data to that granular level. So let's say I want to aggregate data every minute. Just extracting the department name and aggregating based on department name is not good enough. We need to use this information. We have to convert into a timestamp and then we have to round it off to minute and we should be able to perform the department wise traffic every minute by grouping the data based on the timestamp as well as the department name. We will see those details in a moment. Also, one of the common use cases when it comes to building streaming pipelines is to get moving aggregations. When I say moving aggregations, I might want to get past 60 second department wise traffic every 20 seconds. So every 20 seconds, I have to get the data for past 60 seconds and I should be able to compute the department wise traffic. For that, we have an API called as window, which can be passed to group by. It takes three arguments at the max. The first argument is the timestamp field. So once we extract the timestamp from this information, we can convert into a timestamp and we can pass it as an argument to window. And then we have to give the window interval and slide interval. So if I want to get moving aggregation every 20 seconds for past 60 seconds, then 60 seconds is the window interval and 20 seconds is slide interval. So whatever is passed as part of the slide interval should be the value which we should use as part of write stream to trigger at that interval. So we have to ensure that the trigger interval is same as the slide interval when we actually start writing the data in streaming fashion. So that being said, Spark Structured Streaming and data frames provide you all these capabilities to get not only department-wise count or any aggregation in streaming fashion, but also we can actually compute based upon certain windows using slides. As we have spent enough time to understand the data frame operations as well as Spark SQL earlier, I am not getting into too many details about the APIs that can be used for processing the data using either data frames or Spark SQL. You have to go back to the earlier module and you have to understand all the APIs and you have to come again here if you are not sure about those APIs. We will just take this problem statement and come up with a solution and then we will demonstrate that we are able to compute department-wise traffic every minute and also department-wise traffic every 20 seconds for past 1 minute and we'll take it from there. Now let us come up with the solution for our problem statement, which is nothing but department-wise traffic every minute. For that, first I'll be launching SBT console, which is nothing but Scala-based REPL with all our dependencies that are defined as part of build.sbt. Once Scala-based REPL or SBT console is launched, we can actually copy-paste from here to here, which will take care of creating the Spark session object by name Spark, which can be leveraged to read the data in streaming fashion using format as socket and options such as host and port number with appropriate details. And also we have imported functions. As lines is created, which is nothing but a data frame, we can use APIs such as select to project the data or with column to project the data, APIs such as filter or where to filter the data, APIs such as group by to group by particular field. In this case, if you look at the log message from which we are trying to get department-wise traffic, we have the endpoint here. We need to check whether this endpoint have department in them. And once we check that, we have to extract this information, which is nothing but department name along with the timestamp. And to get department wise traffic every minute, we can discard the seconds and we can go get only up to minute, and we can use that information as part of the key along with the department name to get the count. First, let us come up with the logic to extract this value and compare with the department, so that we filter out all those log messages which does not have department endpoint in them. The logic can be like this: val department lines equal to lines dot, either we can use filter or where, both are synonyms to each other. As part of the filter, we can actually use the other functions such as split to split the data. So in this case, we have to split twice like this. The first argument for the split is nothing but the field name, which is nothing but value in our case, because we have only one attribute as part of our data frame, which is nothing but value. So we are trying to split that one itself, and we want to split by space, so we can do, or we can perform split by this method. And then we have to extract the seventh element to get this portion. You can count. The first one is times IP address. The second one is this one. Third one is this one. Fourth one is this one. Fifth one is this one. Sixth one is this one. And seventh one is this one. Once you get this, you have to split again with forward slash and extract the second element to compare with a constant value called department. The reason is because we'll be using forward slash as delimiter, the first element in the array will be empty value, and the second element will contain this department. That's why we have to read the second element in the array after splitting by forward slash. So I can say comma forward slash is the delimiter, and then 1 to access the second element. And then we have to compare it with department. And when it comes to Scala, the programming language, and when we use data frame operations such as filter like this, we have to use triple equal to while filtering the data. So this will take care of filtering out those log messages which does not have department endpoint in them. Once we've filtered for those, we have to now select the visit time as well as the department name from our input data. And the way we can do it is like this. So I will be improvising on top of this filter itself instead of creating a new variable. Once we filter, we can say either with column or select. It doesn't matter. If you want to say with column, you have to say with column twice. If you want to select, you can say select twice. However, with column, you have to drop the value so that we only have department name and visit time to get the count. So I'll be using with column approach. So in this case, I'm saying with column. The first argument is nothing but the alias for our derived field. In this case, I'm naming it as visit time. And then second argument is the logic such as split, extract the time portion of our data, and also convert into timestamp. So we have to set two timestamp because this is the higher level function which we have to use to convert our timestamp into timestamp data type. It is a good practice to convert it into original format, otherwise it will be represented as string type itself. So as part of the two timestamp, we have to use split because we have to extract this information. And also as part of two timestamp, on top of the string on which we want to convert into timestamp type, we also need to specify the format as second argument. And hence after splitting and extracting the time, we have to specify the format, and hence I have the comma here. So as part of the split, we have to pass the value, which is nothing but of type string, and we have to split by space. And the fourth field is the date and timestamp. So this one is 0, 1, 2, and this one contain the timestamp. We don't need milliseconds for our solution, and hence I am discarding this. So once we get this, whatever format the string is, we have to specify that as part of our logic. So in this case, to convert this to timestamp, I have to pass the format like this. Square bracket, the first one is date, then month in three characters, and hence we have to specify capital M's like this, and then Y. Then we have colon, and we have time in 24-hour format, and hence we have to specify capital HS like this, and then colon, and then MM if you want to capture till the minute. If you want to capture till the second, you can actually say SS here. In this case, I just want to capture till the minute where seconds will be replaced with zeros. Okay, so this is how you can actually get the visit time. Let's make sure that it compiles without any issues. Now we can actually go to the same logic and add additional field called as department name. And to get the department name, we can reuse this logic. Only thing is we have to specify of 2 rather than of 1. That will give us the department name. And then if you hit enter, it will create a data frame. However, that data frame contains four fields, including value. And we don't need value anymore to actually perform the department wise count. For that purpose, we can actually use an API called as drop on top of data frame to drop a particular field and create a new data frame. Now we have extracted the information such as visit time, department name. So here I need to pass the column name value to drop, which I haven't done. That's why it has value also as part of this data frame. So after filter, after extracting the visit time and department name, I have to drop value, which is nothing but the field in our data frame department lines. Now we have only two fields, which are nothing but visit time and department name. Using this, I can actually perform the count like this: val department traffic equal to department lines group by. And as part of the group by, if you want to pass both the information as composite key, you can just say visit time and department name like this. And then you can actually use ag and then count on some value. Either it can be department name or visit time, it doesn't matter. And then we can actually specify alias like this and hit enter. So there seems to be a bug in the code. Let's see what is that. Okay, it is visit time, not department time. That's why it failed. So department lines dot group by visit time and department name, and then ag of count of either department name or visit time. So let me specify visit time here. And now we got a new data frame which have three elements: visit time, department name, and department count. You can actually validate by saying department traffic dot print schema. However, we will not be able to use show to print the results here. Rather, we have to create a query object. We have to pass this data frame name to ensure that our logic is correct. And then you have to specify write stream. Once you specify write stream, the next step is to give the query name. In this case, query name is nothing but department traffic. And then update mode, let's say update here. It's not update mode, actually it's output mode. I'm sorry for that. And then we have to specify format as memory and then start. Now we can say spark.sql select star from department traffic and then say show false, just to get the complete data without truncating at field level. There seems to be some bug while processing visit time, so we need to fix that bug and then we should be able to get the information as expected. Yeah, the problem is I have used off 4 rather than off 3. To read the fourth element, we need to specify off 3. That's the bug we have. We will fix it. We will come out of it and we will actually launch SBT console once again and then we'll take it further. So SBT console is launched and I already have the code snippet which I have developed here. So I will be copying from here to here where we have the fix for our bug. After executing this logic, we have a data frame called as department traffic, which contains three fields, which are nothing but visit time, department name, and department count. So far, we have not used any trigger interval. We just specify something like this, and then we say start. There was no trigger. However, if you want to have a trigger interval, such as 20 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes, etc., then we have to use API called as trigger. And as part of the trigger, we have to pass the interval like this. So there is a class called as org.apache.spark.sql.streaming.trigger, which contain an API called as processing time. And as part of that processing time, we can actually specify the interval at which this job is supposed to be running. If it is 1 minute, we have to specify 60 seconds. If it is 20 seconds, we have to specify 20 seconds, so on and so forth. So let's copy paste this piece also. So internally, it will be aggregating the data every 20 seconds, but as part of our group by logic, as we are specifying visit time and department name, those two fields will be used to group by, but that group by and count will be executed every 20 seconds. And for a given time and for a department name, if there is new data coming in every 20 seconds, those will be added to the previous values. Okay, so that being said, as we have the query name, department name, we can say spark.sql here, select star from department traffic, and then we can say show and then say false to see the results without truncating at field level. And you can see the details here. So every minute, such as 5:20 on 2019 February 11, we got the data for each department. So for 5:20 we have fitness with department count as 2. For 5:21 we have footwear, fitness and apparel. Each of these departments are accessed twice, and so on and so forth. So this is how you can actually apply the processing logic using data frame operations. Now we'll actually see how we can take care of the same logic using Spark SQL. And then we will explore window operations as well. That being said, before we get into the next step, such as processing data using Spark SQL or window operations, let's quit this session gracefully. For that, first we need to stop the query by saying query.stop. And then we need to stop the Spark context by saying spark.stop. And then we have to say quit. Then everything will be closed gracefully and we will be out of this session without any exceptions. Now it's time for us to come up with the same logic using Spark SQL approach rather than data frame operations approach as we have seen here.